The SDSU women's basketball team is now 15-7 overall and 6-3 in league play following a pair of wins at home last week. Aaron Johnston's squad used a huge first half run to beat Oral Roberts 71-46 on Thursday.
Well, the Oral Roberts game was a great game for us, especially on the defensive end. We played well offensively, but we've just put so much time into our defense here lately and trying to improve in some key areas. We did a great job, I thought, overall of being disruptive, taking them out of some of their offensive patterns. We forced turnovers. Some of those turnovers led to some offense and transition for us. And I thought, for the most part, did a very good job on McIntyre. She's just such a good player. People don't realize how good she is. She's not just tall. She's very good. She rebounds well, blocks shots, but she scores. She can score over right shoulder, left shoulder, and if you don't do a good job on her, she can really cause you a lot of problems. So I thought it really started with our defense in that game. And we got down early, but our defense was great to get us back in it, made a nice run there, and it ended up having a very good win.
The defensive effort continued into Saturday in the first game of the Port Classic. SDSU held North Dakota State and Brooke Lamar in check for most of the game and pulled away early in an 82-52 win.
That was another great showcase for our defense. North Dakota State, you know, things kind of start with Brooke Lamar. When she gets big things going, they're hard to stop. I thought we did a great job on her defensively. A lot of her shots were tough, contested, mid-range jump shots. The first time I think we let her get to the free throw line too much, fouled too much. Our help was so late that it just put too much pressure on our defense. This time our help was much earlier. We did a much better job on their post players too. When you go back and look at their interior players, that first game they just really tore us up. I thought we did a great job of fronting and just taking away the things maybe they want to do. And they really resulted in a lot of penetration. Had to go away from some of their main offense into some other sets. So I just think our defensive pressure was the story there as well.
The Jacks have now won three straight, but Johnston says consistency and focus will have to continue in order to have more success.
We just need to continue to be consistent with our defense, but also our offense. We've put so much time into our defense, if all of a sudden our offense goes south, that's not a good recipe either. So we just need to be very, very consistent. And the best thing to be consistent, the best recipe for consistency, is to have seniors play well. And if you look at Megan Watashik, Rachel Walters, and Mariah Claren, all three of those women are playing at a very high level, all in their own ways. They all do different things. It's not as though they all have mirror statistics, but they are all being great vocal leaders for us. They're leading by example, and they are playing very well. So consistency always comes from those players, and just real proud of all three of them, because you know this is their time where they really want to see this team do well. Their careers kind of get culminated in these next few weeks, and I'm pleased with where they're at and really proud of where they can take us, I think.
Now, the team never looks too far ahead, but SDSU sits just one game behind South Dakota in the standings. So to a degree, Johnston's squad can control their own destiny.
To a certain extent, we do. You know, you always want to have a little bit of help from as many people who can give it to you. But we started off in a sluggish way in our league, without a doubt. Lost at North Dakota State, lost to IPY, lost at USD. All three of those games were possession kind of games where we really could have won any of those three games, but didn't go our way, and we got beat. So now there's a lot of pressure to play at a high level if we're going to compete for a championship. We don't have a lot of margin for error right now, because I think some of these top teams are going to play well. USD is doing well. Western Illinois is very good. You got a bunch of teams right behind us that are still kind of in the mix. So there's just too many teams around us to assume that they're all going to take a couple of losses. So we're going to need to play well if we want to be in that mix.
The Jacks have just one game this week, providing some rest and additional focus in practice.
We've had a couple of unusual weeks where we had the Western and almost 8 days off for the Oral Roberts game, and now we have another one where we have basically 3 days now, a day off on Thursday, 2 days of practice, and then Fort Wayne. I think it's a good thing because we can pick out things that maybe we're struggling with. We don't have to worry about a game plan these first couple of days. We can just worry about us and try and tweak some things or fine-tune some rusty spots. And then as we get closer to the end of the week, we'll dig into the Fort Wayne stuff. So, yeah, I think this break hopefully can be good for us as long as we get better at something. If we just show up in the gym and lose that consistency, then that's not good. But I think our seniors will keep us focused in the right direction.
And that game is on Sunday versus Fort Wayne at 4 p.m. in Frost Arena.
Yeah, Fort Wayne's always a tough matchup for us because we want to be big and physical and score inside. They do a good job of taking away some of that. They mix up between man and zone. Last time we got a lot of zone from them. In the past, they've always switched things up between games, but they do a good job of taking some of that away. And then they just put so much pressure on your defense because they can all drive. They shoot it really well. And sometimes that's been an area that we've struggled with. So we've had to mix up defenses. We've had to use some zone against them, some man, just do a lot of things to hopefully take them out of rhythm. But they're a scary team because they've lost a couple games that easily could have won against some of the top teams in our league. And they would be right there in the mix with some of these teams right around 500 too. So it's going to be a big one for us.